Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll be explaining you how to work with this Compare Data Workbook. As you see in my other videos on my YouTube channel, this sheet compares two data, old data and new data, and pastes the changes in the third sheet, or you could call it the changes sheet. So currently I have this data here, which is employee list, where I have ID in column A, full name, company name, gender, job title. For this example, this data belongs to last month of employees, and this data in the this month tab is for the this month. And here these are the changes between these two data. Cell by cell comparison has been done. Now, first of all, your data should be in same structure in all these three sheets. I'll explain you how. So in this example, I have data in column A to E, which is ID, full name, company name, gender and job title. Similarly, in this month sheet, which is the new data, I have A, B, C, D, E, same data structure with same columns, ID, full name, company name, gender, and job title. So whenever you're trying to use this sheet, these two sheets need to have the same number of columns. The structure is most important in order for this sheet to work and give you correct analysis and answer. Now coming back to the changes sheet, only difference is that you need to leave the first column A, which will put this factor tax, which is change, add, and remove. And at the same time, you have to make sure that your data, which was same here, starting from ID to job title, it should start from column B. That's the only difference. So data column will remain same, but it will be keeping the first column A for this tax, which is add, remove, and changes. So here I have a total 5 columns, which is A to E in these two sheets. In changes, it would be 5 columns, but it will start from column B. So it will be B to F. And remember to keep this column as it is, otherwise this analysis may not work accurately. So let's clear this up. And here is the data, and let me explain you this clear data button. If you press this clear data button like this, it will show you an error. So in case by accident you have clicked this button, it will give you one more chance. So if you don't want to clear your data, just click no, and there would be a message that no data was clear, and that's fine. But in case you want to clear this data up, I have created this button. It selects row from row 2 till row 5000. So I'm assuming that your maximum number of data in this analysis would be 5000 rows. But in case you want to have more rows and you want to have a more range instead of 5000, you can update this code accordingly. So we'll go to Visual Basic. You have to go to module called Clear Contents Code. And this particular code, last month, it is in this particular module. So here the first code is for old data. So this sheet's name is old data, and for all the sheets, even if you change this particular sheet name, it doesn't matter, it will work. So just remember, this is for the old data. So old data code has this range 2 to 5000, right? So if you want to make it 10,000 or till the end of the workbook, or whatever number of rows you have, depending upon the version of your Excel, you can put that number here. Suppose you want it till 10,000, you just change it here to 10,000 rows, and it will clear till 10,000 rows, and it will clear everything in all rows. So make sure that you clear your data accordingly. So here you can change the same. Similarly, for this month, if you want to expand the range, you have to come to this particular code called Clear Contents New Data and change this particular number from 5000 to whatever number you want. And similarly, in Changes tab, I also have a Clear Data button. Here also you can change the number in this sixth code, which is actually third code for Clear Data Content. So you have to change from 5000 to whatever number you like. So I'll just change this back to 5000 here, because currently I only want 5000 rows, right? And accordingly you can clear your content with one click. So I have here last month's data, which is also called old data, where I have ID, full name, company name, gender and job title of employee. Similarly, I have data for the current month, or new data, new this month's data, where same employees are there, but there are a lot of new employees added in this particular data set. So let's try to delete few names here like this and see how the analysis will work. Right? And this is this month's data. And I will go to changes and we'll click the compare sheets button here. See, we removed two employees here, rows like this. and it has shown as a removed data. So that is one. And all the employees which are added, which are 19 employees, have been shown as added, and they are colored in green. And this particular employee's job title has been changed, food chemist, so which is my Scott. So let's go to my Scott. He was design engineer in this particular data set, and now he is food chemist. So that change is also reflected here. So this is how this particular compare data sheet works, and is a brilliant for comparing any sort of data. Now, if you want to change this particular name from last month, this month, you have to be careful. You have to go to the code and also change this particular sheet name. So let's go to Visual Basic. And suppose I want to change this to old data, and this particular tab to new data, right? And I'll keep these changes as it is. But if you want to change this to something else, or just make it variance like this, you can do that as well. Now let's go to the code, which is this code, compare data main code. And you have to go to this particular section here, where the last month was. We have to make it old data. You have to make sure that exact name is there. Instead of this month, we'll put new data. And instead of changes, you can change it to variance like this. Now, these are the tags which are put here, which is add, remove, and change. So instead of change, you can put whatever you want. Instead of remove, you can put whatever you want. And instead of add, you can put whatever text you want. So accordingly, it will be pasted here. So I'm not going to change that, but you can do that. And also, if you want to change this color scheme, you can do that as well. So you have to go down here. So this is for remove data. Whenever it's a KS remove, you can change color from red here. Currently I have kept bright red. You can change it to something else, right? So I have changed 25500, which is the color code for this kind of color, red, dark red. And for changes data, you can put whatever color you want. Currently I have put code for RBG 15351 and 0, which is nothing but dark brown color like this here. And similarly for add, I have kept RGB 01280, which is nothing but dark green like this. So you can also change the color of font. I have currently kept it white because all colors are dark. So to give a contrast and easy readability, I have kept it white. But you can change whatever you want in all these three particular codes, wherever there is a changes, remove, and add, right? So you can change these two properties, color of font and background, and accordingly you can have your analysis the way you want. So this is how you work with this workbook. It is a fantastic workbook. It is available only for $5 for you to download. The link is in the description of this video. And if you want some special help with this sheet, and if you want to make this particular sheet the way you want without doing yourself, I can do it for you. So for that, you need to contact me on my email ID, which I have left in the description, and I'll be happy to help you. And one more warning for this particular workbook. Don't try to import this code to your own solution or your own particular project files. I highly suggest you use this particular sheet itself and build around your solution. For example, if you want to add more sheets for analysis, any kind of analysis you want to do based on this particular report or variance report, you can do the same using this sheet. So you can make as many copies of this particular workbook and try to build your solution around it. Rather than importing this code to your own solution, it will just be more difficult for you to manage VBA. That's about it, guys. And let me know if you have any thoughts. And I'll be happy to answer any of your queries.